Let me give you some ideas on how to promote independence in young children. I'm often asked, how can I support independence in toddlers and preschoolers? What are certain things that I can do at home to support my children in their journey? And we all know how crucial independence is for children. Every human being wants to be independent. And even though it may look like that sometimes we enjoy people doing things for ourselves, long-term psychologically, every human wants to feel that they are taking decisions for themselves, that they're independent. And in case they're not, then they have this feeling of frustration, anger, and worthiness. We also know that independence is highly correlated with self-esteem and confidence. And we know that our job as parents is to support our children in their journey towards independence. Our job is to raise them in such a way that one day they can be fully independent and they can be autonomous. Children are born with the inner drive for independence. From birth, the moment they can make something, that they can do something for themselves, they want to do it for themselves. They want to sit, they want to crawl, they want to talk, they want to walk, they want to feed themselves, they want to explore things, put things in their mouth. They have the inner drive, the human tendencies, as per Montessori, for independence. So you may ask, if the children were born with the desire to be independent and we parents at the same time know that our job is to help them be independent, what makes it so hard? Why do we struggle so much with the concept of supporting them being more independent humans? And there are a few things that are the main obstacles in the way, I would say. The first one is time and inconvenience. As much as we enjoy being parents and doing things for our children, it's much easier if we take ownership and do it instead of them. Nowadays, it's much harder to carve this one additional hour in the day or to carve more time because we live in a very hectic world. There is so much going on, so much on our plate, that it's simply inconvenient to let children do things for themselves because it tends to get messy, it tends to get hectic, and we just don't invest the time needed. Second thing is love. We come with the desire to care and the need to care for our children, and we have this nurturing nature. We just simply enjoy our connection and we enjoy taking care of them, and that includes taking over and serving them for far, far longer than they need to be served. And the third one is our unconscious satisfaction from having someone who depends so much on us. There is this internal conflict that although it takes so much on us, such a toll on us to take care of our children, at the same time, we really enjoy this feeling of someone being utterly, utmostly dependent on us. Quite often we cajole, we demand, we request from our children to do things, and we basically stop them from being independent. So now that we know the main obstacles on the way, I can give you some examples of things that you can do at home that can support your child in their growing independence. I divided this in separate categories, but they're very self-explanatory, and there are so many opportunities in day-to-day life to support them in their quest for independence. So the first one is regarding dressing up. This includes putting their clothes on, jackets on, cardigans, zips up and down, putting their hats on, putting socks on, t-shirts, pajamas, and then putting their shoes on and off. The second category is self-care, brushing their teeth, in which case I suggest you always help them until they master this skill because you still want them to have healthy teeth. Supporting them in teaching them how to comb their hair, how to sneeze in a tissue, how to wipe their nose when they have a runny nose, how to wash their hands, to apply soap, how to adjust the temperature in the tub when they want to take a shower. There are many opportunities in day-to-day life that you can teach them these things. The third one is in the housework. There are so many jobs we can give them, including swiping, hoovering, taking care of spillages, taking care of tidying up the environment, putting away their toys, which is their responsibility from very early on, for which though you need an orderly environment and you need to show them where everything lives. Also, mealtimes. Mealtimes provide a great opportunity to teach your child how to use fork and knife, how to cut for themselves the fruits that they eat, how to choose what food to put on, but also how to serve the table, how to remove plates from the table and take them to the kitchen, how to wash dishes. And children, even at the age of 2, 2.5, can do that. They're not gonna do it perfectly, but if you don't let them the opportunity to do it, they won't even try. Also, how to take care of plants and pets if you have. You can teach your children to assume responsibility for feeding them, also watering the plants at home. Another one that is big is letting them speak for themselves rather than you taking over and answering instead of them. And that happens very often just because we always love to talk about our children. And we were somewhere with friends and our child is with us and people ask us something about them. They usually address this question to us when our children are younger. And what we do, we jump into answering, oh yes, little Johnny loves school, he loves coloring, they love doing this, they love doing that, and we don't let our child answer. Sometimes even if the question is posed to the child himself or herself, we tend to answer instead of them. Again, there is a very normal explanation. We think that they're too young to be able to answer. First one, second, sometimes it takes time for them to answer. Sometimes they don't even want to answer and we feel that it's up to us to fill the gap and we don't allow this pause, so we take over. Unfortunately, this in long term, it's not a great strategy because we keep doing that even when they're 6, 10, 12, and then imagine how would you feel if you are sitting somewhere with your friends and your parents are around or somebody else is around and they talk about you when you're in the room. It's not a great feeling. So please don't answer instead of them. Let them speak for themselves. Another one is support them physically. Let them, instead of taking the lift, taking the stairs, going up, going down, support them in if they want to climb trees or other playground structures. Support them in taking healthy risk. Of course, do your risk assessment first, but I feel that nowadays we don't let children engage in anything that in my childhood was considered normal for children. And last one, let them fail. Let them take decisions that they may look to you obviously not the right decision, but let them fail, let them try. Because every time when a child tries something, whether it's to pick up something from somewhere or to clean after themselves or to put their pants, even though it's the other way around, they are resolving a problem. So it's great for their brain. And what we do, we interfere far too quickly. Again, time, it's not our friend in this case. So these are certain things that are very obvious in the day-to-day environment. The most important thing is to allow yourself two things. Time, because you have to invest time, and allow more time in the day so that your child can go slowly through the routine, and patience, because things will go wrong and you would feel like it takes just a second for you to help them. But trust me, when you invest the time and the patience in supporting your child from very early on to become independent, this is an investment that will return tenfold to you later in life. And also requires from your side to use a positive language and to encourage your child in the activities that they're doing. So the first thing is to step back a bit and to observe for a while at which stage your child is. Are there certain activities and skills that they should be able to do right now, they're able to do right now, but you're not really promoting those? Or maybe your child is not emotionally or physically at the stage when they will be able to do these activities. Independence, it's never to be forced. Your child may not be able yet, and from your side, what is expected is to support them, saying, okay, not yet, when you're ready, it will come. When you're ready, it would come. That said though, if you have a child who is already at the stage when you know that they are able to do something for themselves, but they simply don't want to because it requires an effort and they don't want to go there, then it's up to you to say, okay, I feel that now it's the time for me to, by knowing that they can do it, to set the intention to help them and support them and teach them, so I can step back and say, I know you can do that and you can figure it out on yourself, and that's why I'm gonna let you do it. If your child is tired, if your child is not in the mood, it's not the right time to promote independence. So always comes through observation. What are certain things that I observe now going on with my child? And when is the best time to promote and to support them in their journey. So these are some ideas of how to promote independence. I'm very much looking forward to your comments and your suggestions as well. What are certain things that you do at home that promote independence with your young children and preschoolers? I'm very much looking forward to reading your comments. If you like this video, please give me a thumb up and share it with your friends. And I'll see you next week. Bye.
Here we go again.
Mom, what's the corner turn
ahead? We want to go there now, but don't know how to get there. The castle. What do you see with your little eye, Mika?